to get us all in deep shit.
Well, I love when you talk dirty. Get your mad ass in this pool with me.
Hey everyone, I'm Brandon Sparks, and welcome to 80's Emporium, your home for everything 80's. The 80's brought many actors from obscurity to stardom, and one of the biggest stars of that decade was a man named Eddie Murphy.
I have recently been placed in charge of garbage. Do you have any that requires disposal?
After a quiet decade, only appearing in three films since 2010, Murphy has returned to the headlines with his phenomenal performance as Rudy Ray Moore in the Netflix film Dolemite Is My Name.
You know what we should have? An all-girl kung fu army.
And to celebrate what's being called his comeback, let's take a look at the iconic 80s career of that comedy legend, Eddie Murphy. Murphy came onto the comedy scene in 1980 when he joined the cast of Saturday Night Live at the age of 19. During his tenure, he created a number of memorable characters, such as a cynical Gumby, a grown-up Buckwheat, and the hilarious Mr. Robinson.
Hello, boys and girls. We're all alone again today. You know why? My wife walked out on me.
While still on SNL, Eddie made his big screen debut in the buddy cop film 48 Hours. His portrayal of wisecracking convict Reggie Hammond is still considered by many to be one of the greatest acting debuts of the 1980s.
There's a new sheriff in town. And his name is Reggie Hammond. Y'all be cool. Right on.
In the same year, Murphy also launched his first feature-length stand-up special, Delirious.
And no matter what was going on, the ice cream man came and stopped. You be getting some marbles and shit, and you hear, ice cream! Ice cream! The ice cream man is coming!
The album version of this special awarded Murphy the only Grammy of his career.
Thirty
years after the release of Trading Places, the movie's plot actually inspired the United States government to make new regulations regarding America's financial markets. This regulation earned the nickname the Eddie Murphy Rule. Eddie Murphy's worst move in the 1980s was Best Defense. Originally a Dudley Moore war comedy, the test screenings for this film did so poorly that the entire movie was actually reshot and re-edited to include Eddie Murphy in a separate storyline. After the failure of Best Defense and his exit from Saturday Night Live, people began to wonder if Eddie Murphy's star power was fading as quickly as it had risen. But those doubts were soon silenced with the release of a little movie called Beverly Hills Cop.
We're not gonna fall for a banana in the tailpipe.
You're not gonna fall for the banana in the tailpipe?
It should be more natural, brother. It should flow out like this. Look, man, I ain't falling for no banana in my tailpipe. See, that's more natural for us. You've been hanging out with this dude too long.
Today, Beverly Hills Cop is still one of the most successful R-rated films of all time.
It's your destiny to find the golden child.
And it's your destiny to seek some serious psychiatric help.
Originally conceived as a straight adventure film starring Mel Gibson, The Golden Child was actually rewritten as a comedy for Murphy after Gibson turned down the role.
Well, I need to see the plans then for this house because you're making a very big fucking mistake. Get the plans for me, please.
Who are you?
Stop working.
I'm Axel Foley, the Beverly Hills building investigator. Didn't they tell you I was coming?
No. They didn't?
No.
But give me the goddamn plans.
Eddie Murphy, Raw, grossed $50 million worldwide during its theatrical run, making it the highest grossing stand-up comedy concert film of all time.
If you're starving and somebody throw you a cracker, you're gonna be like this. Goddamn, that's the best cracker I've ate in my life.
It was most exhilarating. The Giants of New York took on the Packers of Green Bay. And in the end, the Giants triumphed by kicking an oblong ball made of pigskin through a big H. It was a most ripping victory.
This laugh-out-loud comedy featured Murphy playing multiple characters in the same movie for the first time. It would certainly not be his last.
It's only business.
This is personal.
Harlem Nights was Murphy's directing debut, and still the only film he's ever directed in his career. It was an up-and-down decade for Murphy, but his brilliant career was only just beginning. Now, I want to hear from you. What's your favorite 80s Murphy film? What's his worst? Comment below. Remember to subscribe and stay tuned to this channel for more videos and the chance to win some prizes. Also, be sure to check out the Lunacy Productions online shop for some super cool 80s swag and more. We'll do another video soon. Thanks for watching.
How's that?
see no reason to do it again.
Oh, he's back. The man is out of sight. Ooh, he's a tough son of a gun, y'all. Alias Dolemite.